B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Have you ever gone bowling? What two things make the most difference in whether or not your bowling ball knocks down pins? Well, assuming you're better at bowling than me, and don't just land it in the gutter, your best chance of knocking down pins is to hit them with a heavy ball traveling very fast. Scientifically, we would call these two properties mass and velocity. It turns out that the combination of mass and velocity has a name, momentum. Today, we'll look at how momentum affects objects when they collide, like our bowling ball, hopefully colliding with several pins. But before we get rolling, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to compare the effect of mass and velocity on momentum, explain the conservation of momentum, and give examples of the transfer of momentum in collisions. Have you ever played catch with a baseball? When you were little, chances are your catch partner threw the ball to you very slowly to keep from knocking you over. Now that you're a bit bigger, you can handle a faster throw. Scientifically, what's the difference between these two throws? Their velocity. When an object hits you with a large velocity, it has a large momentum. You will experience that momentum as a force that pushes you backward. If the momentum is high enough, you might even fall over. You can experiment with this by playing catch with a friend or sibling. Try throwing the ball back and forth gently, then launch it to each other with some real speed. You'll feel the change in momentum. But we said that velocity isn't the only factor that affects momentum. It can also be increased with a larger mass. If a friend tosses a tennis ball to you, you can probably catch it easily. But what if instead they take the bowling ball we were using earlier and toss it to you at the same velocity? You would likely struggle a bit more to catch the bowling ball because the bowling ball has more mass and therefore more momentum. We can think of momentum as the tendency of an object to stay in motion. After all, imagine a large truck and a small car on the road, both traveling at the same speed but needing to stop at a red light. Which one will be harder to stop? The truck, because it has more mass and therefore more momentum. What about a case where two identical cars are on the road, also needing to stop, but one car is driving slowly and the other one is speeding along with double the velocity? They have the same mass, but the faster car still has more momentum, so it will be harder to stop. Stopping a moving object always requires overcoming its momentum, and remember that momentum can be increased with either mass or velocity. Did you know that momentum is always conserved? Okay, but what does that even mean? You may hear the word conserve or conservation in other contexts, such as being encouraged to conserve water or learning about conservation efforts for the environment. The word conserve simply means to protect from destruction, but it doesn't seem like momentum is in any danger of being destroyed. In fact, it can't be destroyed. That's why it is always conserved, with no additional effort on our part necessary. It's easiest to see how momentum is conserved when looking at collisions. If you've ever played with matchbox cars, you might be familiar with the conservation of momentum without even realizing it. What happens if a moving car collides with a stationary car? Let's take a look. When the moving yellow car collides with the stationary white car, some of its momentum is transferred to the white car. That's why the white car suddenly moves and the yellow car slows down. The total momentum of the white and yellow car together stays the same. So the yellow car's momentum decreases, and the white car's momentum increases. What if both cars are moving when they collide? Is momentum still transferred? Yes. As you can see, both cars change their speed and direction. Remember that direction is part of velocity, so changing direction indicates a change in momentum as well. When our matchbox cars collided, momentum transferred from one car to the other. That's why collisions can be so dramatic. The momentum possessed by one object can't just evaporate. It has to go somewhere. And most of it usually gets transferred to the object it collided with in the form of velocity. In the case of cars, this can be treacherous. But for our bowling ball, that transfer of momentum is exactly what we want, so that those stubborn pins start to move. As you've already seen in this course, sometimes studying the physical world involves doing a little math, and momentum is no exception. Luckily, the math here is very straightforward. To calculate momentum, we just multiply the two things that cause it. Do you remember what they are? Mass and velocity. So, this is our equation for momentum, P equals mv. But why a P for momentum? Well, what letter would you have picked? M? Too bad, that one's already taken by mass. So we'll have to live with momentum being represented by the letter P. I know it's a little weird. Let's try an example. If I throw a 5-kilogram watermelon at a velocity of 3 meters per second, how much momentum does it have? I need to multiply 5 kilograms by 3 meters per second, and I get 15 what? What's my unit? What units did I multiply? Kilograms and meters per second. So, it may feel a little clunky, but that's my unit for momentum. Kilogram meters per second. And that's all the math you have to do in this lesson, I promise. Now, what about the conservation of momentum? What's going to happen when that watermelon is caught, or more likely smashes onto the ground in a dramatic collision? If the watermelon comes to rest, that means it has no more momentum. So all of its 15 kilogram meters per second of momentum will get transferred to whatever it collides with. I hope the ground is ready. Watermelon incoming! In reality, we know the ground won't move much because it is so massive. But if you are standing nearby, you might feel it shake a little. That's the transfer of momentum. As we went through the lesson today, we saw that momentum is a measure of an object's mass and velocity. When objects have more mass or more velocity, they have more momentum. And this means they have a higher tendency to keep moving, or that they are harder to stop. When objects that have momentum collide with other objects, their momentum is transferred, because the momentum is conserved and can never be destroyed. Whether it's a bowling ball knocking down pins, or a watermelon crashing violently into the ground, the momentum will always get transferred somewhere. Next time, we'll finish up our unit on motion with a look at the energy that arises due to motion. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.